वंदे गुरुपद्वंदम भक्तबिंदसमन्वितम् श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नित्यानंदसहोदितम् श्रीनंदनंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्तं बिंदावन मनोहर वांछा कल्पतरुवश्य कृपा सिंधुवेवच पतितानं पावने भवैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपा तमहं वंदे परमानंद माधव बिंदावई तुलसीदेव भुई पियावई केशव सज कृष्णभक्ति पदे देवी सत्वत्वई नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीरे संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेशे गौरीपत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्त भक्ति प्रमोदाक्ष जगोद्धरुण धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतात्तिहम् पनुतपालभवद्विपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पादपल्लवनखचन्दमनिच्छटाय विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधू स्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिकामयी कदा कृपां करोषि श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकावदातु संकेतनैकपितरौ कमलायताक्ष विश्वाम्बरौ द्विजवरौ युगधर्मपालौ वंदे जगत्प्रियकरौ करुणावतारौ हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वन्दितो दिव्यरूपम् भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासिनित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गङ्गातरङ्गरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागम् नारायणो प्रियमनङ्गमदापहारम् वरानसिपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशजुष्वपदने लक्ष्मीर्यस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित्त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम Hare Ram, Ram Ram Hare. Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena Santaha Sadeva Hidayeshu Vilokayanti Yang Sama Sundaram Machinta Guna Sarupam Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami Premanjana Churita Bhakti Vilochanena Santaha Sadeva Hidayeshu Vilokayanti Yam Sama Sundaram Achinta Guna Sarupam Govindamadi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami Gauriya Goshtipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada Jagat Guru told that Paratpar Akhileshwar Sri Gaur Sundar, he has shown us the topmost procedure of bhajan. Raganuga Bhajan Vichar, Vidhi, it is the topmost of all. And finally wanted to show us the excellency of Radha Anugatha, Manjari Bhav, etc. Actually, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, he couldn't speak all in details about all secrecy. He wanted to speak, but material world, whole world, they are busy with material enjoyment. So much anartha there, so much anartha, so much anartha. They are feeling so much attraction from material enjoyment, material things, that Prabhupada couldn't speak. Prabhupada couldn't get any scope to speak all in details. He wanted to speak all in details about this. Sometime Prabhupada was bound to speak the reason for why I am coming in this material world to keep this secret treasure. But I couldn't give fully because I couldn't find any appropriate person who is a candidate. Not that he is Parsad, outside people. Anyway, actually we know to attain the final goal. Final goal means Krishna Prema. Krishna Prema also under the guidance of Radharani, Manjari Anugatha. That is the final goal. But we should follow the procedure. Without following appropriate procedure, we can never come out successful. That I told repeatedly. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Adhikar na lovhiya siddhadeva bhave, viparjaya buddhi upaje, shaktir abhave. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Bhajan Rahasya that those who are not getting appropriate right, adhikar. Yesterday I was discussing about this point, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that the Supreme Lord going to arrange some benefit for us according to our grade, according to our right. Because not that everybody can start Raganuga Bhajan, everything. Somebody, they are doing Vidhimarga Bhajan also, okay. And the rest of the world, I mean, those who are falling, at least externally, those who are following Vedas, they have Karma Kandi. So according to that, Supreme Lord was bound to segregate the whole Shastra into two parts. One part is that those who are busy with Karma Kandi, they can get some inspiration to follow some procedure. And was Paramarthik, those who are interested in spiritual benefit, for them separate Shastra. Actually, Veda is one and, Veda totally, purpose of Veda is same, but still according to the desire of common people, they can get benefit from Veda actually. So Bhagavan, Supreme Lord, he was bound to make two part Shastra. Those who are following spiritual path, actually interested with spiritual path, they can follow paramarthik shastra. Even in paramarthik shastra, there is so many categories. And repeatedly Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, there is some great idea behind it. Why Bhagavan making this kind of arrangement? Why Bhagavan going to make varnasram, dharma, everything? Why? Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, there is some secret reason. So Bhagavan going to arrange this way so that people can find their track according to their adhikar. To engage them in appropriate track, so according to their adhikar, this kind of arrangement was done by Supreme Lord. But there we see also in Gita we find Chaturvarna Mahasishtam Gunakarma Vibhagasaha Tasya Kartaram Api Vidhimam Akartaram Abhayam. Chaturvarna Mahasishtam Gunakarma Vibhagasaha. This Chaturvarna system, four Varna Evang Ashram, it was also segregated by Supreme Lord Himself because it is very urgent. If people not going to feel any, not going to follow any varna ashram, anything, if they are going to follow their fanciful, mind, then there is a great danger. There is a great danger. If there is no system, nothing, in that case, there will be a great danger. Actually, day by day, sinful activities can increase. Full amount of, sinful activities will be there if there is no controlling. So to control, so to get control over the whole population in the world, dharma, this word is applicable. Maybe Christian dharma, maybe Buddha dharma, they, according to their, idea they are doing, Buddha dharma, Christian dharma, Isai dharma, dharma means to get control over them, their fanciful attitude. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing in Jaiva Dharma, finally, in material level, we can find different kind of dharma for different kind of taste of people. According to our previous karma fall, they choose this dharma is suitable for them. This way they are running. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Atma Dharma, this Jaiva Dharma, Atat Bhagavad Dharma, this is final. Because Bhagavad Dharma, Atma Dharma is, itself eternally present, Sanatan Dharma. It is not created by anybody. It is already there for eternal priya. It is there present. So it is related with our Atma, spirit. So it is the final Dharma. But those other dharma, we cannot fight with them. Gradually, they can follow their dharma. And gradually, they can follow their dharma. And finally, ultimately, they can feel that it is not sufficient. We need more. So, when they are really interested about spiritual improvement, then they can search. They can search out. They can search out. Actually, they can, and if their luck is good, they can get chance to follow. This way, Bhaktivinoda Thakur yesterday I told that it is still good. It is still good to follow gradual promotional procedure. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, it is still good to follow gradual promotional procedure. But it is not at all good to jump up. It's very dangerous. In that case, they cannot get success. They cannot, sadharma, if they are going to violate, paradharma bhayavaha, I can discuss also tomorrow. Paradharma, sadharma nidhanam seyo, paradharma bhayavaha. Sadharma, if you like to follow your own dharma, still it is okay, according to our previous sanskar. If you like to violate it and like to follow another dharma, which is not matching with your present situation, sanskar, is more dangerous. So, sadharma nidhanam seyo paradharma bhayavah. This we should remember it. But yesterday I was discussing the painful situation prevailing all over the world. They are not going to follow the exact track. They are not going to follow they are jumping. So this way they are going to lose their minimum benefit. They are going to lose their minimum benefit, which was already there with them. Still they are going to lose it. So this is Rai Ramananda Sangbad. Through this Rai Ramananda Sangbad, actually Sri Sriman Mahaprabhu, though Paratparakleshwar, Supreme Lord, but still now in the form of devotee, he was busy to preach this Vishuddha Dharma, Harinam Sankirtan, everything. And in different place, Mahaprabhu, in course of his traveling, South India, here, there, he was traveling and wanted to establish this pure Bhagavad Dharma, Atma Dharma, Prem Dharma. So, in course of his traveling, he was there in, you know, Vidyanagar, one place, you know, Andhra and Orissa border. There is Vidyanagar there. And there this Rai Ramananda Sangbad, this discourse took place at the bank of Godavari in Kovur. Very nice place. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to express the inner meaning of our Bhagavad Seva. What is the inner meaning? What is the final goal? So he wanted to express all in details. That's why Rai Ramananda Sangbad, this is one kind of, you know, one kind of very, very secret, you know, knowledge, secret procedure through which gradually we can understand what is the procedure, what is the condition at present, how we can go up this way, actually. But yesterday I was discussing that those who are without achieving their capacity, if they are going to violate their present, you know, adhikar and try to jump, in that case, anyway, artho paramartho, nothing they can get. They can lose everything. Very. So, Ladini Shakti, Ladini, try to understand, Ladini Kripa Saidini. Ladini Kripa Saidini mean, when who can get Ladini Kripa, there is no surety, no guarantee. There is no guarantee how and when you can get Ladini Kripas, because Bhakti Devi Param Satantra. Bhakti Devi is never controlled by anybody. Bhakti Devi Satantra. So when Bhakti Devi can show Kripa on whom, that is a question. So I told yesterday also that Jajati and Sobhari Rishi, somehow they could arrange their good ultimately. They were expressing and they were repenting repeatedly because of their previous activities. And there was no complication inside their heart. There was no complication, there was some mistake, but there was no complication inside their heart. That's why they got the opportunity to come out, they could realize their fault. And those who are having kapat bhav, you know, there is a duplicity. If they are trying to get bhakti, they try to show that our stage is very high, our, you know, adhikar is very high, but they can never get kripa. This is a big problem. I can give example that Ladini Kripa Sairini, no amount of logical interpretation cannot stand in the way of getting this Ladini Shakti, Kripa Bhakti. Then we will have to go deep into the philosophy. that Pingala Visha. What was the reason? We cannot understand why Pingala Visha got the chance to get bhakti. Ultimately, he was feeling detested, you know, was feeling disgusted. Ultimately, he took decision. He was speaking, she was speaking, that I am foolish, whole life, whole day, I miss my everything. Actually, if I could love this Param Purush, Parat Parakhileshwar, you know, then I could get advantage. But now I am searching, you know, who man can come in front of me this way. I am losing my time and everything, all my valuable time. So, Pingala Vesha, and also I can give another example, the pros sent by Ramchandra Khan in front of Haridas Thakur. Now, ultimately, they got the opportunity to get bhakti, Shaddha Siromani, love. Shaddha Siromani, Shaddha Mane, Shaddha Sadhan, and Shaddha, ultimately they could get prema. There was Lakshahira, she was established in Harinam, totally, by the mercy of Haridas Thakur. So, when who can get this kind of bhakti is just, there's, you know, no surety. Also, I can give the example that brahmachari, noistic brahmachari, from inborn, he was brahmachari. His name is Shuklambar Brahmachari, Paya Pankari. He was busy to drink milk only. He was habituated to drink milk only, nothing else. So Poyapankari, noistic brahmachari, also see, he couldn't get bhakti. In Chaitanya Charitamrita we can find. So Mahaprabhu was very angry when this Shuklambar Brahmachari, Poyapankari, who was habituated to drink milk only, Mahaprabhu was very angry and speaking, "What do you think? You think that you are doing some astrology and finances and you are drinking milk so you can get me? What do you think? You can get entry into my Rasa Leela? I mean Sankirtan Yaga Leela?" This way Mahaprabhu was chiding him. So we see, even this noistic brahmachari, so much astrology and finances is doing, but ultimately, he couldn't get the chance to get entry into this Rasa Leela. Is a Rasa Leela mean Rasa? There is Rasa. There is so much Rasa flowing there, but he was not allowed to get entry there. So, Mahaprabhu speaking, very, you know, loudly Mahaprabhu speaking, Asuro tap kare tahe ki baphal. Those asuras, they are also doing astuti and finances. So what? You know? Hiranyakashipu doing tapasya, so many tapasya, but after that, what kind of tapasya? Na bhutam na bhavishyati. This kind of tapasya, Brahma speaking, nobody done before, and now in future we cannot expect this kind of astuti and finances, you know, somebody can do, we cannot expect. Na bhutam na bhavishyati. But still, what was the success? No success. He couldn't get prema, no bhakti, nothing. Ultimately, he was busy with material achievement, material improvement, position, and la puja patisha, everything. This is our situation also. This is our situation also. Situation is very painful. We are going to imitate, because we can point out, oh, Mahaprabhu told in Vidyanagar, Mahaprabhu also told in Vidyanagar. It is external, go on speaking all deep philosophy. It is also external, you go on speaking about deep philosophy. We can imitate Mahaprabhu. But we forget, Mahaprabhu is the teacher of Trinadapi Sunijbhav, is the total embodiment of Trinadapi. Even Prabhupada, Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Bhaktipurna Purigashima, they all are the embodiment of Trinadapi. They are Trinadapi, totally, all the time. They are Trinadapi. Because Radha Dasa, those who are actually doing interested, which is the final goal of this, you know, Raya Ramananda Sambhava, they are already established. So that's why this kind of humble attitude, this kind of Trinadvi Bhav is quite natural with them. But we are habituated to speak Yahvajjo. It is external. Go on speaking more. You are external. It is external. Also, you can go. This way we are imitating Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to prove that we are elevated sadhu. This much we know. We know nothing, only this much we learn to imitate Mahaprabhu. That is external. You go on speaking more. Whereas we cannot prove that we have minimum amount of right, minimum amount of quality we have, that we cannot prove. But we can speak very easily. You know, it is external. That you learn. Like I told you, one parrot, I told many long time before, one parrot was there, that parrot was taught by his master to speak one very nice sentence. What is that? That was almost a forest area, not totally forest, outside forest, very nice. So sometimes those hunters, they are coming to for hunting. Beasts and birds, sometimes birds especially, they are coming. So that master teaching to giving a lesson to this, parrot, that whenever, whenever anybody coming, that parrot was taught to speak this thing. What is that? That the hunter can come and make some network and catch you and go. Be careful about that. Always talk. Shikari aayego, jaal vichayego, tumko pakar ke le jayego. Saavdhan rehna. In Hindi. You must be very careful. A hunter can come and make some network and catch you and go away with you. Be careful. But the parrot, no idea about what parrot speaking, no direct relation, only memory, only from memory. And that parrot speaking from memory, not out of realization. So this way, one day one hunter came, making some network. That hunter wanted to catch this parrot because the parrot was not there in chain. Open, because it is pet parrot. And the hunter, he was offering lucrative offer, very nice fruits, so that parrot can feel greedy and can jump. It was so. So when the parrot could saw that there is one lucrative offer, then jump into that net, and from net, when the parrot was inside net, it was caught by the hunter. Still, that a parrot speaking, that hunter can come, make one network, can catch you, go away, be careful about that. This is the condition with me. Is a condition, our condition this way. So we learn this much. But we have no desire to start pure bhajan. Those who are really interested to start pure bhajan, they can follow, surely they can follow the gradual promotional procedure written in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. They must follow. In Jayava Dharma, they are in Chaitanya Sikshamrita, Mahaprabhu Shiksha, they can follow. Now point is that Shuddha Bhakti, pure devotional practice, we don't like to start. We are interested to prove that we are attaining high quality, high grade, adhikar. So this much we learn, that we are not expressing your desire from heart for pure devotional practice. We are not going to express this kind of bhava. So this way actually we are starting. But we forget that in Gita also, in Gita where basic things are written, somebody speaking, Gita is basic thing, we need not read it. But they don't know if they have no basic idea about Gita. they can never come out successful. They think it is you know, kindergarten teaching. So we should not learn Gita. They are white, but they don't know. If they have no basic foundation of Gita, their total being can collapse very shortly. If they have no basic, you know, foundation of Gita, no knowledge about Gita, total, they can, any time they can collapse. Their building of spiritual building, they can, you know, bhajan, they can collapse. They don't know. There actually, when Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking that sarva dharmanam parityaja mamekam saranam bhayo aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshai shami masucho. So aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshai swami masucho, it is my commitment, I can deliver you, I can save you. So sarva dharmanam parityaja, all type of dharma you should live. All type of dharma you should live. All type of dharma they should live. And mamekam saranam bhajam means only and only you will have to show submission unto my lotus feet. Only this much you will have to. Sarva dharmanam parityajam mamekam saranam bhajam. You can't mean it. Totally you will have to show your submission unto my lotus feet. Sarva dharma means different kind of dharma what you are following. Any different kind of dharma you are following. And in, you know, sometime you are doing mana dharma, social dharma, you know, sarir dharma, body related dharma, or any dharma you are following, Christian dharma or anything. But Bhagavan Sri Krishna putting this kind of instruction, that any kind of dharma you should leave, you are not going to get any result, bad result for that, because I am there. I promise you. Sarva dharmanam parityajya mamekam saranam bhajo aham tvam sarva papebhyo mokshai shami masucho. You need not repent for that, I can deliver you from that. But sarva dharmanam parityajya mean all you will have to leave everything. Mamekam saranam bhajo mean who? Try to understand. Mam ekam saranam bhajo mean you will have to depend upon the lotus feet of Krishna only. Only and only you will have to depend upon Krishna. That is called submission. And this kind of submission, how we can expect from you? When you are going to show submission unto the lotus feet of Krishna, then automatically it becomes Bhagavad Dharma. You see, try to understand. When you are going to leave all any kind of dharma that so long you are following, when we are going to leave everything and going to fulfill this condition, that sarva dharmanam parityajya mam ekam saranam bhajo, only and only. In that case mean, you will have to show 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Not to any demigods, nobody, nothing. Sarva dharmanam parityajya mam ekam saranam bhajo mean there should not be any desire also. That means automatically it is going to prove that it is called Bhagavad Dharma. So Bhagavan Sri Krishna is going to give you instruction to follow Bhagavad Dharma, nothing else. And what is the excellence of Bhagavad Dharma? Well, Bhagavad Dharma is such a unique dharma that if you follow this Bhagavad Dharma, you need not play your head over your duty and, you know, anything. You have your responsibility, duty, everything. You have your life. You need not play your head over that, because anyway you are not going to get any punishment if you are going to violate it. But if some duplicity there, then surely you can get punishment. So about Bhagavad Dharma in Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, it is written, there is Bhagavad Dharma, what kind of excellency there? Bhaje jano asthayo naro rajan na pramaddet karhichit धावन निमिल्यो बा नेत्रे न स्खलित न पतित इहो. वर स्पीकिंग जानो अस्थायो, इफ ही इज गोइंग टू टेक शेल्टर ऑफ दिस भागवत धर्मा, हे राजन परीक्षित, देन यू आर नॉट एनी बॉडी, दोज हु आर गोइंग टू फॉलो दिस भागवत धर्म फ्रॉम हार्ट, they are not going to get any punishment, any result, bad result, nothing. Because janu asthayo naro raja na pramadit karhichit. They are not going to meet with any trouble and mistake. No, not possible. Dhavan nimillova netre. Even you are going to close your eyes, you need not see anything about your, you know, present, everything, but, you know, adha dharma, nothing. Dhavan, dhavan nimillova netre, na skalet na pate diyo, there is no chance of fall down. Because it is the responsibility of Supreme Lord. Supreme Lord told, it is my responsibility. It is my responsibility to guide you, to save you. Provided you are sarva dharmanam paritejo mamekam saranam bhajo, that is the final advice of Gita. Now, so-called acharyas, they are speaking, you see, this is the basic point. No, we need not. They are thinking, we need not follow it. As the so preliminary thing. But they forget that where Bhagavad Gita, I know, where Bhagavad Gita going to end is, where Bhagavad Gita, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, where going to end, I mean final conclusion, from there, Bhagavad Dharma starting. They forget this point, that where Bhagavan Sri Krishna going to draw some conclusion with this point, that sarva dharmanam pratyajo mamikam saranam bhajo. There actually, when Gita going to stop from here, actually our Bhagavad Dharma starting. I mean the entrance and the entrance gate is very narrow. Prabhupada speaking, the way, I mean entry, gate, entrance is very narrow. You cannot get entry. That is very, very check off. But once if you are allowed, if you can get entry, then you can find immense amount of treasure. Immense amount of treasure there, in infinity. But before that, there is so much check-up. You have to prove that you are qualified, not before that. So I know where Gita, Bhagavad Gita going to end. That is the starting point of Bhagavad Dharma. That doesn't mean it is the starting point, kindergarten says, so I can throw it, not that. Because without this foundation, without this basic thing, even you cannot get entry into Bhagavad Dharma. You can make Tilak Mala. Who is going to stop you to make Tilak Mala? Who is going to stop you taking red cloth, blue cloth, white cloth, whatever you can take danda, whatever you like, you can take. Who is going to stop you? But you cannot get entry into Bhagavad Dharma. That is the basic point, starting point. So, first of all, we should understand this point. Sarva dharmanam paritejo mamekam saranam bhajo aham tam sarva papibhyo mokshayishyami mas. That is the responsibility lying with Supreme Lord. Nityananda also, I told you, that is the responsibility. Supreme Lord means Nityananda also Supreme Lord. Nityananda, in his Nityananda stakam, we find there. Ato bhosham saram buditarana dayo mailaget. Nityananda Babu speaking, the whole responsibility lying with me. You need not repent for that. You need not play your head over that point. Ato va sansaram buddhim. You know, I can help you to cross this material ocean. Ato va sansaram buddhi tarano dayo mahira. The total responsibility lying with me. Same thing Krishna speaking actually. But different kind of anartha there inside heart, different kind of duplicity there inside heart. As so, we cannot prove 100% submission. The day we can show 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Guru Vaishnava, then surely we can get entry into Bhagavad Dharma. No problem, no. But before that, we can have different kind of demands and expectation. But still, if there is no complication inside heart, that is a vital point. Maybe you have some anartha, maybe you have some desire inside your heart, material enjoying mood. That's not a big problem, but there should not be any complication. that I can take shelter of Guru Vishnava, I can take shelter of Harinam and go on fulfilling my, you know, desire in my life. That is great, I mean, offense. So this kind of if complicacy is not there, then there is no problem. Then somehow we can cross this material vasan by the mercy of Guru Vishnu. That's why yesterday I was bound to speak that akamaha sarva kamo ba muksho kamo udarodhi tivrena bhakti yogena jayeta puramam purusham param. In course of your anugatya, in course of your bhajan, harinam, sankirtan, everything, you are going to cut your anartha gradually, and finally, if you can cut total anartha, then you can get chance. So anyway, if you have desire, still you will have to worship Krishna, not any demigods. Not any demigods. But we know, actually, in Bhagavatam, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking, Arjun, four types of devotees, four types of people, they are worshipping me. Chaturvida bhajante mam sukritino arjunaha arto jigyasu artharthi cha gyani. You should remember. Chaturvida bhajante. Bhajante, chaturvija bhajante. Bhajanti mam, you know, sukritino arjunaha arto jigyasu artharthi cha gyani. Four different kind of categories are there of devotee, bhaktas. Some they are artha, they are in painful situations, so calling like Gajendra. Gajendra is the example of artha devotee. He is now in painful situation, now calling, you know, do you going to do bhajan of Supreme Lord? So chaturvidha bhajantim, bhajantim ham. Sukritino arjunaha arto jigyaso artharthi chagani. So arto means Gajendra. Gajendra is the example. He is also doing bhajan. So in Kartik Vrata is the instruction, standing instruction, that we should follow this, you know, Gajendra Mukshan Lila to understand our painful condition, how to go out. Even in the morning time when you break your sleep, then you will have to remember that picture, that Gajendra is in problem, and Bhagavan Hari coming with wheel, jump, and I'm going to save this, and it's very good. Because there's a commitment. Bhagavan Sri Krishna, Hari speaking, those who are going to remember this, you know, this thing, then when they are going to leave their body, at that time, I must do kripa today, the standing instruction. So you must remember. So, Jigyasu, if you put question, Jigyasu Arjun. Arjun is a Jigyasu, is putting question. Parikshit Maharaj also Jigyasu. And Artharthi, who is going to get some benefit, that's why he is doing bhajan. That is actually Dhubo Maharaj is the example. Dhubo Maharaj is the example. You know, this way, you know, Gyani Prahlad Maharaj, Gyani. This way, Ganchar Bhakta. So, Arto, Jigyasu, Artharthi, Chagyani, four different kind of categories we can find. Those who are really going to start their bhajan or doing their bhajan. Anyway. So, four different categories are there. But Chaitanya Mahaprabhu wanted to prove that those who are going to expect something and with different kind of demand they are doing bhajan, they are not going to satisfy Krishna fully. They cannot satisfy. Only full satisfaction can come when you are totally free of any desire, expectation, nothing there inside your heart, and only your desire is to give full satisfaction to Supreme Lord. To give full satisfaction to the Supreme Lord, you must know all devotional procedure, how to do. Because if you try to calculate, you cannot understand. So gradually, by the mercy of Guru Vishnu, you have to understand how to satisfy Supreme Lord. the best possible way. We have to find out this way. Sometimes, without attaining our right, we want to prove that we are already doing. Like one example giving by Prabhupada in Upadesha of Upakshan, one book very nice where Prabhupada speaking that one gulikhor, a tobacco, special type of tobacco, and a two friend, one, and a two men, they are, you know, friend, they are coming at the bank of river. They like to enjoy, you know, smoking. Guliko. Guli means one kind of special preparation of tobacco. You know, they like to. It is one kind of intoxication. Now, two of them already in intoxication. One of them speaking, I have some, you know, this facility to, we can enjoy. Well, yes, why not we start? Well, how to start? There is no fire. There is no fire. We need fire to start, you know. And then another who is there is the other pen is speaking, why there is no fire there, over there there's fire there, that is that side of river. Prabhupada giving this example, you know, they are catching already in their mouth to get the fire from their hair at the bank of river. And they looking fire that side of the river. They say, why not? There is fire. You look, there is fire. Why not you take fire from there? Yes, they are going to take fire from there, you know, mentally. This is the condition. Prabhupada speaking, those who are gulikhor, gulimana intoxication, they of la puja patishta, everything, they are not going to think with cool brain what achievement we can get. Even we have no karma misra adhikar, you know, the basic thing actually, varnasam dharma. Varnasam dharma, in there actually, varno and ashram, this was said, Bhaktivinoda was speaking, to organize the whole society. If there is no proper arrangement of varnasam dharma, then everybody can follow fallible mood and they can get destroyed. That's why varnasam dharma, these rules and regulation is very, very urgent in preliminary stage. Those who are going to break all rules and regulation, they cannot get success anyway. They cannot get success. That's why gradual promotional procedure, the first of all, actually it is written, that a varnasam dharma, it was first spoken by, when I can first speak about the introduction about how this Rai Ramananda Sangha took place. Actually, Sriman Mahaprabhu, when after taking sannyas, wanted to go to South India for preaching here and there. So, that time, Srila Sarvam Bhattacharya, he was requesting Sriman Mahaprabhu, Prabhu, you are going to South India, you know, pilgrimage. So please, it is my request, you can meet with Rai Ramananda. Why I am speaking, why I am going to request you, you can realize when you can meet him. He is a very rasik bhakta. But externally you cannot understand, he is rasik bhakta. Externally he is busy with, you know, all material work, you see. He is the governor of Vidyanagar. You cannot understand, externally you cannot understand, he is such a great devotee. External arrangement cannot allow you to understand, like you know, Pundarik Vidyanidhi externally is like material man, but still he was not a material man. Gadadhar Pandit doing this kind of lila, Mukunda taking Gadadhar with him because he has some, he like to see a great devotee, he is hearing for a long time. A Pundarik Vidyan is a great devotee. So let me see what kind of great devotee he is. I can pay Dandavad and get Kifa. This way Mukundo and, you know, Gadadhar Pandit is going there to say, to pay Dandavad. But the external, in a situation, in external condition was so confusing. Because he was sitting like Jamindar, great landlord, big king. with all back brass hair, with very nice oil, everything costly, you know, and very nice essence, when a scent coming, very nice, chandan tail, everything, you know, and chewing betel, you know, leaf, with, you know, very enjoying mood externally, and there is one pot where you can spit, and the bed is very nice, like, you know, butter, so nice, soft bed, and there is also, up the bed, there is one also covering, it is called Samiana, very nice covering, you know, and the bedstead is very costly, like kingly arrangement. There was kingly arrangement there. So when, you know, Gadadhar Pandit went with Pundarik Vidyanidhi to see Pundarik Vidyanidhi with Mukunda, he was in confusion. This is one kind of leela. He thought, I was thinking that devotee must be, but what I see here? He was in confusion. Ultimately, Mukunda could realize that Gadadhar could not understand the mood of Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So immediately, to prove the heart of Pundarik Vidyanidhi, he started speaking one sloka of Srimad Bhagavatam, Barha Pira Natavarabhu Karnayo Karnikaram, this sloka. On hearing this sloka, Pundarik Vidyanidhi is, you know, he is feeling ecstatic feeling. Like mad. He is going to tear on his nice dress, you know, like mad, crazy. He fall down from the best state, all gone, you know, arrangement all, mismanagement, all breakdown. And started crying, Oh Krishna, my father, Krishna, my father, Krishna re bapre, this way. Then Gadadhar Pandit was thinking that I couldn't realize him first. Now I realize that the great devotee he is. But in preliminary stage, I couldn't realize. Oh, I have done aparad unto his lotus feet. How to cut this aparad? So I must take diksha from Pundarik Vidyanidhi. So Gadadhar Pandit took diksha from Pundarik Vidyanidhi. This way actually, Gadadhar Pandit finally could realize the heart. But here I see, you know, first of all, when Mahaprabhu was requested by Sarvam Bhattacharya while he is taking preparation to go to South India and tour, then Sarvam Bhattacharya is requesting, Prabhu, externally you cannot understand, if you can meet him, then you can realize why I am speaking this way. So what a great devotee he is, you know, because I know your heart by now. So you can meet him surely. That is why Mahaprabhu also was interested to meet him. So now Mahaprabhu going to South India, and in the way of South India, and you know, Mahaprabhu going, and all devotees following him up to which point? Up to, you know, that place with name is Alarnath. Up to Alarnath, and from there Mahaprabhu with very neutral mood started running like lion. And all devotees, they fall down on ground, they are crying, they are feeling the separation of Prabhu, and Prabhu going and speaking, Krishna, 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 Keshava, Pahi Maam, Rama, Raghava, Rama, Raghava, Rama, Raghava, Raksha Maam. You know, this way, Krishna, Keshava, Krishna, Keshava, Krishna, Keshava, Pahi Maam, this way Mahaprabhu speaking. When Mahaprabhu starting that time speaking this way Mahaprabhu chanting, not Mahamantra. Mahaprabhu, why? Somebody is saying, why Mahaprabhu usually speaking Mahamantra? Why at the time of going to South India, Mahaprabhu speaking Krishna Keshava, Krishna Keshava, Krishna Keshava, Pahi Maam, Rama, Rama, Raghava, Rama, Raghava, Rama, Raghava, Raksha Maam. Why speaking this way? Has some inner meaning. What is the inner meaning? Because South India is full of Mayavad. South India is almost full of Mayavad. Mayavad Siddhanta Vicha, pure devotional practice is almost not there. Though we can find some Ramanuja followers there, Madhvacharya followers there, Nimbarko, Vishnu Swami, but still, this they are following, but still, Mahaprabhu speaking this way so that no problem can touch. No problem can touch. Even if you meet with one Pasanda, I was discussing this point yesterday, not clearly, not fully. I told yesterday that Prabhupada speaking, it is the instruction. It is the instruction of Srila Prabhupada. It is the standing instruction of Srila Prabhupada to avoid bad association. Bad association, I was explaining, bad association, dusangi, if Prabhupada speaking, if this bad association, dusangi, is only busy with sinful activities, not doing any Vaishnava aparad. Dushangi yudhi, if they are actually busy with sinful activities, that's still okay. But if they are committing big Vaishnava aparad, in Vaishnava Vidyeshi, they are against Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, or Vaishnava aparadi, anyhow, you will have to avoid them. Anyhow, you will have to avoid them. If you are not going to avoid them, then knowingly or unknowingly, you can get some association with them. Yesterday, when after speaking Harikatha, I was crossing river, I meet with one sannyasi, very small age. I used to love them very much, but with some bad motive, they took sannyas. He took sannyas. They mean I have some group, but especially I meet with him yesterday. All rubbish activities he was busy. Age is not so high. With bad motive took sannyas, but there is anartha. All rubbish activities doing, but what to do? I was in boat and he come and paid underwater. He was bound to speak something, but I was feeling bad to speak with him. But it's prohibited. What to do? No. So, dusanga, asasanga tag is Vaishnava achar, already I told. So, if asasanga, dusangi, if not only busy with sinful activities, having also Vaishnava aparat, then you will have to avoid them totally. It is the instruction standard. Asasanga, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, stri sangi ek. One is Trishangi, Yashishangi, as per Gaudiya Siddhanta. Many times before I explained, Yashishanga means Bhakti Mataka speaking, with enjoying mood, whatever you are looking, that is Yashishanga. With enjoying mood, what you are feeling, that is Yashishanga. Enjoying mood, anything you are. So Krishna Bhakta, Sri Sangha hai Asadhu or Krishna Bhakta. Sri Sangha means Yashish Sangha. Yashish Sangha doesn't mean only woman. Because you should know the background. Yashish Sangha doesn't mean only Sri Sangha, doesn't mean only woman Sangha. Those who are women, if they are having some enjoyment with men, they are also, Yashish Sangha for them. So Mahaprabhu speaking, as per the Siddhanta of Mahaprabhu, Sri Sangha, ek asadhu, those are busy with in different kind of enjoying mood, Yashish Sangha, or Krishna Bhakta, they are not Bhakta of Krishna, ek asadhu. Krishna Bhakta, Krishna, they are not at all devotee of Krishna. Krishna Abhakta, they are not devotee of Krishna. And this area covering Mayavadi, Nirvisheshvadi, Adhakshik, or Krishna and those who are going to attack Krishna and Krishna Bhakta, all covering this field. Krishna Bhakta, they are not devotee of Krishna, mean surely they are Mayavadi or Nirvisheshvadi, Adhakshik, depending upon their assumption or sense organ, they are going to depend upon their sense organ. They are all Adhakshik. They are going to depend upon estimation. They are going to play their hand. So Krishna Bhakta, Mayavadi, Nirvisheshvadi, Adhakshik, those who are going to attract Krishna and Krishna, Krishna Bhakta, all this area covering. Astri Sangi, if Stri Sangi, Jashe Sangi, Stri Sangi, if at all not going to do any Vaishnava Para, then somehow Guru Vaishnava tried to help him. If there is no Vaishnava Para in their life, only they are, you know, Stri Sangi, Jashe Sangi, Stri Sangi. So Jashe Sangi doesn't mean that Vaishnava Aparad must be there in him. Jashe Sangi, it can also so happen that Stri Sangi only is busy with, you know, Stri Sangi, Asa Sangha also, and still, you know, he is not doing, committing any Aparad, Vaishnava Vidyesi. He is not having any fighting mood with Guru Vaishnava, Vidyesi mood. So, somehow we find in some place, and those who are Stri Sangi, somehow they can get benefit. Like, follow. Like, you know, Billa Mangalji, he got benefit. You know, this way. So, those who are Vishnu Vaishnava Aparadhi, those who are committing Aparad unto the lotus feet of Vishnu and Vaishnava, Nirvisheshvadi, those who are, they should keep silence. They should avoid their association anyhow. Anukhan Harikatha Kirtan, continuously Harikartha, those Vaishnav, they are busy with continuous Harikirtan. Still, if they find one Vaishnava Aparadhi there, they are not bound to give answer to their question. They can keep silence. Follow what I say. So they are not going to mukobat. Mane, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that Bhaktivinoda speaking, Vaishnav charitra sadai pavitra jeninde hingsakori bhakati vinod nasambhasetare sada thake maunodhari. Bhaktivinoda speaking, those are pure Guru Vaishnav, if somebody going to attract him, those Vaishnav, if they are somehow going to having some, you know, fighting mood, for them Guru Vaishnava always going to keep silence, not going to speak. Though speaking all Siddhanta Virod, Rasavad, Vaishnava Aparad, Guru Vaishnava not going to, you know, even speak with him. They like to maintain silence. They can keep silence. So Mukhopad Avasthan Koriben, Prabhupada giving instruction. Those Guru Vaishnava continuously speaking Harikatha Kirtan, still, if they are going to meet some Vaishnava Aparadhi this there, they need not speak with him and avoid. So, in Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran, Balaji Maharaj, because if you don't understand this basic thing, anyway, never you can get bhakti. It's a basic thing. In Bhagavad-ji Mahapuran, there, Balaji Maharaj, when going to make some understanding with Duryodhan, then they are insulting Krishna. They are insulting Krishna. Krishna insulting, speaking all rubbish against Krishna and Jaduvamsa. Then Balaji Maharaj was very angry and started, you know, taking action. But before taking action, Balaji Maharaj speaking, Pashu Ulam Laguru Yatha. The total sloka is there. In Bhagavata, Balaji Maharaj speaking, Nunam Nana Matonyadhya Santim Nechanti Asadavaha Tesam Hi Prasamo Dandaha Pashunam Laguru Yatha. Nunam Nishita Meva, surely those who are puffed up so much vanity, you know, they never want to get peaceful solution. So puffed up there. Nunam Nana Mato Nadhya Santim Nechanti Asadavaha Tesam Hi Pasamo Dandaha Pasunam Laguru Yatha. They are puffed up with, you know, their feeling. Janme Sarjo Suto Sibi Redo Mano Madahap Pamano Naiva Arhati Abhidatumbi Tamakin Janago Charam Kunti Devi speaking. They are puffed up, they are taking birth in a high family, good looking, very high power in their body, so much affluences and there with them. So Janmo Isojo Suto, also having some knowledge also, Vidya, though this Vidya is not favorable for bhakti, that's why Bhaktivinoda Thakur, whatever amount of material education they can have, if it is not favorable for bhakti, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, jara vidya yato mayar vaibhav tomar bhajane badha anitya samsarel lobo janmiya moho janmiya jibke kare gadha. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking that whatever amount of education can be there with them, if not favorable for pure devotional activities, pure bhakti, in that case it is useless. That educational qualification can make that man or woman a ash. Ash means who is going to take burden on head. Without burden, a ash cannot run. Always need some burden on backside. So you see, Bhaktivinoda speaking, jara vidya yato mayar vaibhav tomar bhajane badha anitya samsare moho janmiya jibke kare gadha. Those jivas, they are taking different kind of form, human body. If they are going to get huge education, big education, everything in this material world, anitya samsar, unstable this life, if their education not going to help them to serve Krishna, I mean, if it is against devotional activities, then it is one kind of burden. So jara vidya yato mayar vaibhav tomar bhajane badha anitya samsare moho janmiya jibke kare gadha, can make that man or woman an ash, nothing in. They like to take some burden, big burden on their head. So abhakto micha bhakto, abhakto is not at all bhakto, and micha bhakto false devotee. You should have analytical idea about it, because otherwise you can never avoid asasanga. In your whole life, if you go on hearing harikatha, if you don't understand this you know point, then never you can avoid asasanga. Asasanga you cannot avoid. So anyhow you can get some asasanga and can fall down. Never you can make some improvement in your bhajan. Abhakto means those who are not going to do bhajan. Those who are not going to do bhajan of Krishna. People, even common people, they have no idea about akarma, karma, akarma, vikarma. In Gita, Bhagavan speaking all basic thing. Karma, akarma, vikarma. They have no idea. So how they can protect themselves? They have no idea about karma. Akarma, vikarma. They have no idea. So basic thing you must understand. Those who are following general rules and regulations, they think that we are under the category of, you know, we are following Veda. They are not going to follow Veda properly. You know, so rare thing, you know. Tar modde mukha vancha koitya bhavadan, you know, mukha vancha is there, so different kind of desire there, and so much population here, and in this creation you can aquatic elements and you know those, you know, animal and man there, out of that tirjak, jalachar, khechar, those were, you know, moving around in the land, some flying in the sky, some in, you know, the aquatic element, so many jivatma there. Among them, if you like to short out, you can make human race is very, very, in a amount, in a number of human beings is very small amount. After that, if you cut, then you say they are not civilized and nothing, they are like brutes, you know. Then you can, you know, try to understand that the population of such a man, who can understand Veda, who like to, this category is very small amount. After those who are really following Veda, still more rare. After that, those who are busy with karma, you know, those who are with jnana, karma, everything. And devotee is a matter of joke. Devotee is a matter of joke. How we can get devotee? Where we can get devotee? Well, Maharaj, thousands of devotees there. Yes, thousands of devotees. This kind of devotee is actually almost rare. So you see, first of all, you should understand karma, akarma, vikarma. Karma, akarma, vikarma mean actually karma mean what is prescribed in what is already prescribed in Veda. What is prescribed in Veda? That is called, if you can follow, that is called karma. That is called karma. If you are not going to follow Veda, and then it's okay. Still, it is okay. If you are just going to do opposite, then it is dangerous. If you are going to follow what is rules and regulations written in Veda, it's karma. It's karma. But if you are going to not follow, still okay. But if you are going to do just before, just opposite of what written in Veda, that is vikarma. So karma mean the instruction there in Veda, is instruction written in Veda, according to that you are going to follow karma, is karma. And akarma mean not to follow that Vedic injunction, not to follow. And vikarma mean just to do the opposite of what is written here in Veda. It's more dangerous. It's very dangerous. So, bhakti, actually, you must be very careful about that. So, if you search out, you can find how many people they are busy with, Bhagavad Dharma. How many people? How many people they are busy with Bhagavad Dharma? You can search out. It's very rare, very rare, very rare. So, we cannot expect everybody, they can start Bhagavad Bhajan, Hari Bhajan, not that. So, abhakta means those who are non-devotees, but micha bhakta means those false devotees. Micha bhakta means a false devotee, not devotee at all. So, abhakta and micha bhakta praviti swahit, Prabhupada speaking, with all of them, so-called bhakta, they are not at all bhakta, going to take some undue advantage, this, that, micha bhakta, false. Not following any rules and regulations, nothing. Weakness can be there. That doesn't mean weakness can stay for infinity period and we are busy with some. There is no desire to change their life. So, abhakta means those who are non-devotees, and micha bhakta means false devotees with tilakmala, everything they want to prove, but they are not at all interested to follow Bhagavad Dharma. Not at all. They have no sincere effort on their part. So this way, Balaji Maharaj speaking, so those who are not going to get some solution, peaceful solution, is so much popped up with Janma, Isharja, Suto, Siddhya, so popped up. Ultimately, it is a procedure to apply the fourth in a principle. Fourth principle is beating. Pashu nam laguro yatha, I will have to give punishment. Pashu nam laguro yatha. This principle is applicable there. But Bhaktivinoda Thakur also going to give us advice, because everybody not Balaji Maharaj, so they can open, they can open their sword and cut them, give punishment, not that. So everybody not Balaji Maharaj. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving permission, Bhaktivinoda give this, Pashunam laguro yatha min, Bhaktivinoda speaking, you will have to avoid them from heart. Maunodhari. Prabhupada speaking, this principle is more effective. You should not talk with them, non-cooperation, no, nothing. No comment, not even prasad exchange, nothing. No exchange with them. This is applicable. Tibro sikhabal. Bhaktivinoda speaking, Je Vaishnav Charitto Sadai Pavitto Jain Inde Hingshakuri Bhakti Bino Bhakti Bino Na Sambhashitare Sada Thake Mounodhari. Always is going to, keep silence. So, those who are having the full effect of Rajatama Guna, those who are having full effect of Rajatama Guma Guna inside their heart, totally. If they are going to show, if they are going to speak that Yehova Jyagi Kahova, this is, you know, joking. Whereas their heart is full of, Rajatamaguna, but they are busy to speak that this is external. You can go more deep philosophy you like to hear. This is on one kind of joking. We should not follow this procedure. So this way, when Mahaprabhu going to South India, in the way Mahaprabhu speaking this kind of mantra, I mean Krishna Kesava, Krishna Kesava, Krishna Kesava, this way, Rakshamam, this way, so that Mahaprabhu, we can learn something from this. Why Mahaprabhu speaking this way? Because South India is a total belt, almost full of Mayavad. So Mayavad, Asasanga, Dushanga, you know, Abhakta, different kind of Sangha can be there. So that's why Mahaprabhu praying unto the lotus feet of Krishna. Rama Raghava mean Raghav Ram mean Nacha Ramchandra. Here. But in Mahamantra, this Ram, you know, this Krishna himself. Radharani with Radharani is, you know, doing Leela. That's why here in Mahamantra this Ram is Krishna, Ramanath. Radha Sahitena Ramanath Rama Iti Uchate. With Radharani she is enjoying, that's why it is called, you know. That way is where Ram. Actually this Ram doesn't mean Balaram. This Ram doesn't never. Our, you know, Raghunath Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami Pad, Gopal Guru Goswami Pad, Bhakti to all our Guru Bhargava giving this meaning, more deep meaning, you know. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, you know. Hare Radharani. When, how, what is the mood? There is so many difference there. So, when Mahaprabhu going to South India speaking this, to teach us how to save yourself. All the time you'll have to pray unto the lotus feet of, you know, Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. You need full protection. Otherwise you cannot understand when you can get Mayavad Sangha, when you can get, you know, Asasangha, different kind of Asasangha you can get. That's why in the way, when Mahaprabhu while going, first Mahaprabhu started then speaking this mantra. After that, when reaching, after that, when Mahaprabhu went to reach, you know, Vidyanagar, there Mahaprabhu actually sitting under a tree, banyan tree, big trees, at the bank of Godavari Nadi, you know, and doing Harinam from heart. That time actually, Mahaprabhu doing Harinam there, chanting Harinam, at the same time, Rai Mahasaya, Rai Ramananda, by the desire of Supreme Lord, is coming there with full musical instrument, everything with Brahman, Pandit, you know, there, with their coming, gradually, with musical instrument, because externally, I already told, externally, Rai Ramananda, you can find busy with some Vedic ritualistic activities, this, that, Rai Ramananda busy with that, externally you can find. But actually not that. Rai Ramananda is a great devotee, eternal parshad of Gauranga Mahaprabhu. So, actually, Rai Ramananda is a great devotee, you can get evidence here. So this way, when Rai Ramananda coming with full musical instrument, everything, that time Mahaprabhu was sitting there, but Rai Ramananda could see that there is Dibba Sannyasi, very, very powerful Sannyasi, as if thousands of sunlight there, glowing. So Rai Ramananda was interested to approach that Sannyasi, Rai Ramananda gradually, and those Brahman Pandits, they are actually surprised to see that our Rai Ramananda, Rai Mahasaya is never, we saw this kind of mood. So, Rai Mahasaya coming in front of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, I mean Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, paying dandavat unto his lotus feet. And after that, After that, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you know, he is paying Dandavat, prostrated Dandavat and crying, and Mahaprabhu going to help him to get up and embracing each other. After that asking, you Rai Ramananda, asking this way. Then Rai Ramananda, humbler than a blade of glass, but to speak, Radha Anugatha is already there. So that's why Rai Ramananda speaking, yes, I am actually Shudra. Vishayi Shudra Mandha. Vishayi Shudra Mandha means I am a material man. Vishayi Shudra. Shudra means low caste actually. Mandha. Rai Ramananda, you are right, but I am Vishayi, material and fallen soul. Like this, this way, Mahaprabhu going to identify, Rai Ramananda going to identify himself in front of. So this way actually, gradually they are discussing with each other, embracing each other. That time those who are Karmakandi Brahman Vaishnava, those who are Karmakandi Brahman, they are very surprised to see the mood of Rai Mahasaya. Because they never saw Rai Mahasaya expressing this kind of mood. Externally they saw different kind of mood. Very, you know, personality, heavy personality. Why going to shed tears, everything this way? So this way actually, Rai Mahasaya discussing with each other. Ultimately, Rai Mahasaya could understand because there is eternal relationship there. Gauranga Mahaprabhu also could realize the heart of Rai Mahasaya, their eternal parshad. So they could detect each other. So Mahaprabhu wanted to meet him in the evening time. Mahaprabhu wanted to meet him in the evening time when the official job, everything is over. Then Mahaprabhu wanted to meet with him. And Rai Ramananda took permission. And in the meantime, one pure Brahman going to invite Mahaprabhu. So for some days Mahaprabhu was there at the bank of Godavari, and there in the house of that Brahman taking some madhukuri there. And each day in the evening time, after completing all official job, everything, Rai Mahasaya used to come in front of him to do satsanga, to get satsanga. This is called actually satsanga. Their internal mood is almost same, but still their internal mood is almost same. And it was the mood of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Paratpara Kirisa. Mahaprabhu wanted to unveil the total mystery of bhajan life. So that gradually from 1, 2, 3, 4, actually finally where to go, what is the final goal, Mahaprabhu wanted to, you know, show in front of us. It is true that we are, if we are Gaudiya devotees, it is our final goal to get that Madhurasa Bhava. Already Prabhupada told, yes, tomorrow I can discuss in details. But point is that if there is no, yesterday I was discussing, if there is no strong desire, if there is no strong desire to cut material bondage and all different kind of, you know, and a procedure, you know, karma mark, everything, varnasam dharma, after the Mahaprabhu first speaking, what? You know, first, Rai Mahasaya, in front of Rai Mahasaya, Mahaprabhu wanted to put some question. So, Mahaprabhu, Rai Mahasaya started expressing, I like to hear some sadhu sadhan tatta from you. So you please, you know, speak in front of me, please. Then Rai Mahasaya started speaking first about from Vishnu Puran. Rai Mahasaya wanted to quote that Varnasam Dharma, but to take the help of Varnasam Dharma. And after that, karma mishra archam, you know, karma mishra, You are doing, or if you are following some procedure, but karma misra, having some karma, contamination. So, varnasram dharma, if you are going to follow varnasram dharma, man, Mahaprabhu going to speak, it is piranavas. Man, through this procedure, we cannot give full satisfaction to Krishna. It is one kind of, you know, preliminary thing, very preliminary, not Shuddha Bhakti. That is why Mahaprabhu told, it is external. Age kahoar. After that, actually, it is external thing, so you please tell me something deep. So after that, Raimahasaya started speaking about Krishna Karmarpan. Karmarpan, whatever you are going to do, that you will have to offer unto the lotus feet of Krishna. So first procedure, I can go back again to discuss the present situation. Now, from Vishnu Puran, Parasar Ukti, Parasar Rishi giving advice, Varnasramacharavata Purushena Paraha Pumano Vishnu Raradhati Pantha Nanatattosho Karanam. Varnasram Dharma is the very nice procedure through which, and all people, they can try to get to try to worship Bhagavan. This is the procedure. Raimahasaya first told him. Varnasramacharavata Purushena Paraha Pumano Vishnu Raradhati Pantha Nanatattosho Karanam. There is no other procedure to satisfy. For general people, this is a procedure. So on gradual, in gradual course, they can go and get some good in their life. Mangal. They can get mangal. This is the procedure. But Mahaprabhu speaking, it is external. Why? Because Varnasram Dharma, it is they are confined with inside this Varnasram Dharma regulation. Without Varnasram Dharma, total system, Vedic system can break down. That we know. But this is not final. Varnasram Dharma is not final. To categorize, to give some system, to follow some system, rules and regulation, Varnasram Dharma is surely is a basic thing. We need it. But it is not the procedure through which we can satisfy Supreme Lord. That is why you can remember when Bhagavan Sri Krishna discussing with Sudama Vipro. Sudama Vipro, they are also speaking there, Sudama Vipro, that this way we cannot satisfy. We can follow Varnasam, this, that we can do, but this way fully we cannot satisfy fully. So, that's why Mahaprabhu told it is external thing. You please go, you like to deep. Then, Raya Ramananda speaking, Krishna Karmarpan. Whatever you are doing, in Gita we find, Yad Karosi, Yad Asnasi, Yad Juhosi, Dadasi yat, yat tapasasi kantiyo tat kurusha madarpanam. Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking in Gita, Arjun, whatever you are doing, yat karushi, yat asnasi, whatever you are eating, whatever you are doing, chagya, yat juhosi, dadasi yat, whatever doing, donation, dan, whatever tapasa you are doing, kantiyo he Arjun. Kunti Putra, the son of Kunti, you know, you will have to give everything to me. This is the procedure. And Sudama Vipra already told, as Sudama Vipra, in front of Sudama Vipra, Bhagavan Sri Krishna told, that Naham Ijya Prajati Bhyam Tapaso Upasamenava Tuseyam Sarva Bhutatma Guru Susso Sayayatha. Naham ija, ija means puja. Naham ija prajati bhyam. Puja prajati bhyam means varnasam dharma. Family life you can lead, you know. But staying inside family life, you can get the maximum most benefit. Shonvai Bhakti Mithagur Popadvi. No. Bhagavan Sri Krishna ultimately And in the Chaitanya Lila also we can see so many documents, you know. So naham ijja prajati bhyam tapaso upasamenova tapasya upasam tapasya adi, you know, tapaso upasamenova tu seyam sarva bhutatma. Tu seyam sarva bhutatma mean I am staying inside the heart of everybody. Tu seyam sarva bhutatma guru shusho sayayata. Who is guru? By the if you can do Sarv Gurudev, Sadguru, then I can become very satisfied. So, it is true. So, through Guru Seva, Bhagavan, but who can do Guru Seva? Again, you have to go back and understand, you know, who is, you know, in a condition to serve Sadguru, and who is Sadguru, all you will have to remember previous discussion. Then you can apply this formula here. And Sadguru is maybe Sadguru, but that doesn't mean that Sadguru is busy with Braja Rasa Bhava. That's why I told now, that's why Mahaprabhu was speaking yesterday. Sikishno Rasa Bhavita Mati. Sikishno means Mahaprabhu wanted to speak about Bhajandanandan. Mahaprabhu, after Sanya, when speaking this point, then surely Mahaprabhu wanted to speak about Bhajandanandan, not about Mathuradish Krishna, Dwarakadish Krishna, not at all. So, when Mahaprabhu is speaking, that you must be sure that here Bhagavan speaking about Nandanandan Krishna, Bhajandanandan Krishna. So, Naham Ija Prajati Bhyam Tapas Guru Seva. So, if you are doing Guru Seva, that doesn't mean that you can get Prem Bhakti, this which is available inside, you know, Prem Bhakti means Bhaja Prem Bhakti. It is not sure. It is not sure because maybe your Gurudev is Sadguru, but no, you know. So when Mahaprabhu is speaking, Krishna Bhakti Rasa Bhavitamati Kriyatam Yadi Kutopi Labhate, that surely means Mahaprabhu wanted to speak about Nandanandan Krishna, Bhajandanandan Krishna. So Sadguru, through Sadguru Seva, surely you can get Vaikuntha realization. You can get realization power, everything. You can get chance. But only through, only by the help of Braja Rasa Rasik Bhakta, only by the help of Braja Rasa Rasik Bhakta, you can get the chance to get this kind of Raghavanuga Bhakti. Not that everybody can get it. Not that. Not that everybody can get it, not that. So, Raghanuga Bhakti is not a matter of joke. Nagarunga is not a matter of joke. So, in course of discussion, you can find that it is the instruction in Gita that jat karosi, whatever you are doing, whatever you are jagya, whatever you are doing, sacrifice, what tapasya you are doing, what you are giving donation, all you should do, you should offer to me. This is also one kind of procedure. Those who are actually paramahansa, those who are paramahansa, rajhansa, paramahansa, they are always busy with that kind of thing. Paramahansa in the line of Raghanuga Bhakta, their position is so high, that they are busy with transcendental love affair with Krishna, eternal seva, Brajaras, they are in the ocean of Brajaras all the time. And those who are not actually, they are going up to Vaikuntha Jagat, not Golok Dham, and even in Golok Dham, this Prakashtaji's chamber, and Vrindavan, inside this Vrindavan. Those kind of devotees, they also can be paramahansa, but this, our Gaudiya, in our Gaudiya field, they are paramahansa, the exclusive bhava. They are busy with always rasa seva. They are busy. So now actually, paramahansa, the designation is not applicable here, everywhere. If we like to imitate, it's a big problem. So in general sense, we know those are dark. Dark means general. Dak means pati has. The dak always taking some useless thing at the bank of pond. good and very bad things taking. But Hansa, you know, Paramahansa is, you know, Jyotivas Hansa, he always busy with taking Mrinal inside core of lotus flower. So you try to understand those were material people, their mood, and those were Hansa, Paramahansa, they will have to, they different kind of grades are there. This way, so if one crow, Prabhupada speaking, if one crow like to decorate his total body like a mayur, peacock, is not possible. If one crow like to be a peacock, is impossible. If one crow like to become a peacock, it's impossible. How it is possible? Crow is crow, and peacock is peacock. Prabhupada speaking, if somebody going to artificially decorate is everything like peacock, still it is not possible. For some day he can make some acting, but after that the naked picture we can see. It's all useless. So for some day he can cheat people, ultimately he cannot prove that he is Raganuga Bhakta, Rupanuga Bhakta. Not possible. A crow is crow. So crow if going to, but in devotional life is so complicated. You know, Chaitanya Charitamrita is written there, Kakere Gorur Karo, Eitumar Gun. Vaishnava, those who are pure, they have so powerful, they can make a crow, even they can make, it is written. So much, we are singing, we are speaking this katha, Kakere Gorur Karo. It is one kind of, you know, humble mood. Kakere Guru Ka, you are so powerful, you know, like in Chaitanya Chaitanya, you can find the Sarvamottaja is speaking. I was like jackal, always busy with, you know, Mayavad. Now, you are going to change my heart totally. So, this is one kind of humble mood. It is there. Kakere Guru Kato. Kakere Guru Kato means, even a pure Guru Vaishnava can change your heart. You are not crow. They can change you, convert your heart, change your heart, so that you can get Vaikuntha Seva like Gurur Bhagavan. This is written. Gurur Bhagavan means that doesn't mean you can become Guru. Not that. You can do Seva like Guru, he's busy, always doing Seva for Krishna. So, Kakere Gurur Karo Ehi Tumar Gun. Vaishnava Thakur, Guru Vaishnava, they are so powerful, they can change my heart and give me service there in Vaikuntha Dham, as Gurur Bhagavan is busy with, always busy with Seva. But somebody, he is so popped up, going to speak, Gurur Bhagavan is there staying in Vaikuntha. So I am less interested to go to Vaikuntha. I like to go there in Vrindavan, like to get Seva in Vrindavan. Even when Uddhavji Maharaj speaking, I like to become a, I like to get one dust particle from the lotus feet of this book. Asa maho charanarenu, jusa maho sam, yesterday I told. Pure devotees, those humble. They are expressing this kind of mood. Those who are popped up, they straightway like to jump and they like to become gopi. They are going to jump into fire. This is the procedure they like to follow. So, this way, they can never come out successful. So many people, they are going to ignore Varnasam Dharma, Karma Misarshan, Karma Arpan, Karma Yog. But you can remember, even those who are doing bhajan in different procedure, Ranti Dev, he was busy with Karma Mishravakti. Whereas, Jarabharaji Maharaj was busy with Gyan Mishra Bhakti. Jarabharaji and Bharatji Maharaj, not Jarabharat, but Jarabharat they took name after, first Bharatji Maharaj. Bharat Maharaj was busy with Gyan Mishra Bhakti, whereas Ranti Dev was busy with Karma Mishra Bhakti. So Gyan Mishra Bhakti, in this discussion, Rai Ramana Sangha, you can find, is far better. Gyan Mishra Bhakti is far better than Karma Mishra Bhakti. But still, Bharatji Maharaj was not successful, whereas, you know, Rantidev was successful. Why? Because Rantidev was following exact track according to his right. Rantidev was following exact track according to his right, not only that, but also the basic thing of karma mark, you know, karma visra bhakti, you should feel that in everywhere, and you should see the relationship of the whole world in relation to Krishna. If you are not going to see the whole world in relation to Krishna, then karma mishra bhakti is not successful. So in the life of Rantidev, you can find when Rantidev, the great king, he was giving punishment for some time, testing. Within that period, Rantidev was successful. You know, everything gone, not even water, food, nothing. But still, Rantidev going to pray unto the lotus feet of Bhagavan Supreme Lord, O Prabhu, I like to suffer for all jivatmas. You give all pain to me. I like to suffer on behalf of them. You make them free. This was the mood of Rantidev. Rantidev wanted to suffer. He liked to help those jivatma to go out of danger, bondage. This. So Rantidev was successful because Rantidev was busy to see the whole world in relation to Krishna. So that is why it was successful. Now he was successful. He was serving jivatma whenever they in trouble, no food, no water, nothing. They are giving everything. Even he himself fasting for, you know, long period, giving everything, you know. But he was successful in his bhajan. But Bharatji Maharaj, he was supposed to come out successful, but he couldn't come out successful simply because his attention was diverted. He was doing Gyanamishra Bhakti, feeling everything in the morning time before sunrise, going to the river Gandaki Nadi, taking bath and facing east direction, Suryadev. They are going to think Gayatri, every mantra, chanting everything and feeling with knowledge, Gyan. He is feeling, you know, everything. This way he used to do Archana also, coming back, collecting fruits and flowers. But you know everything. Still I like to remind you that someday he was in Maya because one deer, baby, he was, you know, floating into water, going to die. Somehow, Bharatji Maharaj thought, it is my responsibility. He was thinking that it is my responsibility to save that baby. Mother died on jumping into water because of the fear of lion backside. She was drinking water. Now, in fear of lion backside, jumping into water, but heart fell. Immediately die, and that baby taking bath in the water and floating and going away. Bharatji Maharaj was there watching this. He thought that I must save that baby. So he was bound to save that baby, taking care of that baby. That was not bad. But the point is that while serving that baby, he was giving service to that baby deer. And ultimately his attention was diverted from Hari Bhajan. Gyanamishra Bhakti, if you can follow properly, that is also way somehow you can get. You cannot get Braja Prema, but you can come out successful. Anyway, but he was not successful because his attention was diverted. Then after that, what happened? He was busy with the seva of that dear baby all the day and night. Maya. Maya re koriya jai, charano na jai, sadhu guru kipa bina na dekhi upai. Ultimately, he was in full Maya, He was full busy with that dear baby. He was arranging food and everything for grass, everything for, and all archan procedure, all bhajan procedure, all gone down. His temperament, you know, now going to lose patience, everything. This way he was gradually, he was going, you know, gradually he was busy with, you know, gradually he was busy with that Maya Seva. So finally, when that dear baby was lost in the forest, he cannot find, he was crying, ultimately with this kind of feeling, jang jang bao pi saranam bhajam bhavam tajiti anti kalevaram. According this formula written in Gita, he was bound to take bath in the form of dear baby. Kalanjar Pradesh is one another place. From there, that Bharaji Maharaj in the form of deer, he was bound to come back to his original bhajan spot. Because his, you know, total memory was not lost because of Hari Bhajan. Like Gajendra. Gajendra was in problem. But Gajendra, in previous life, he did bhajan, so he is not going to remember everything. So this way, Gajendra also could remember, and he also, Bharatji Maharaj could remember, but now coming and shedding tears, oh Prabhu, I was doing some nice bhajan, due to my own mistake, now I fall down, how to it? Ultimately going to leave the body in Gandaki water, and you know, always crying and repenting. Finally, he was given chance to take bath in the form of a Brahmin boy, you know, Angiras Gotra, very nice Brahmin family, yes, Jarabara. By that time, Bharaji Maharaj was going to express himself as useless, dumb and deaf, Jarabara. So, Jarabharat Maharaj was bound to follow this procedure because otherwise Asasanga can come and again can make him fall down. He already confessed in front of Rahugan. Oh Rahugan, I was falling to follow this procedure because otherwise I can get Asasanga, I can fall down. This life, I don't like to miss this life. So this way actually, Bharaji Maharaj was not successful in the procedure of Gyanamishra Bhakti, whereas in the procedure of Karma Mishra Bhakti, Rantidev was successful. So now actually is going to speak that so this way actually Mahaprabhu in the evening time when Rai Mahasaya, Rai Ramananda coming in front of Mahaprabhu, then started discussing so many things. First of all, general discussion going on. Mahaprabhu discussing with him. When Rai Ramananda coming, paying prostrate attention, Mahaprabhu sitting. So, actually Mahaprabhu started discussing with him. First of all, praising and glorifying that your father, Bhavananda Raya Sambandha Bolchen, your father actually Bhavananda, and you are Sakshat Pandu, and Tumar Patni Kunti, in front of Bhavananda, Mahaprabhu in Nilachal Dham, Mahaprabhu was speaking in front of Bhavananda, is that you are actually Bhavananda, you are actually Pandu. Your five boys, they are actually your five boys, they are five Panchapanda. This way, Mahaprabhu glorifying his name. This way. So after that, Rai Mahasaya, you know, is sitting in front of him, and Mahaprabhu asking that I like to get detailed information about Sadhu Sadhan Tattva. And Sarvam Bhattacharya especially giving me instruction to meet you. Sarvam Bhattacharya lady is already speaking about you. And Sarvam Bhattacharya giving me instruction, Prabhu, you are going to south, you must meet. That's why I am coming here to meet you, Vidyanagar. Mahaprabhu. So, that's why in the evening time, when Mahaprabhu actually, Sarup Damodar Lalita Sakhi, and Rai Mahasaya, Rai Ramananda is Visakha Devi. We know it. So Sarup Damodar Prabhu is Lalita Sakhi, and Sri Rai Ramananda is Visakha Sakhi. So, it's not a matter of joke. He's sitting and Mahaprabhu's Shaddha Sadhan, in course of discussing this Shaddha Sadhan Tattva discourse, wanted to express the extreme point of Shaddha Sadhan Tattva. That's why. So, first of all, Mahaprabhu speaking, I like to know Shaddha Sloka Ninnoy. You'll have to identify one by one. Paro Sloka Shaddha Ninnoy. You'll have to recite the sloka which is related to Shaddha, you know, general Shaddha. Rai Kahe, Rai Mahasa speaking, Shadharma Acharane Vishnu Bhakti Hoy. Rai Mahasa speaking, you know, Shadharma Acharane mean, actual Varnasam Dharma actually, I already told. So, Varnasam Shadharma Acharane Vishnu Bhakti Hoy. Sadhu Sadhane Dara, why you are doing sadhana to get, what is your target? By the help of sadhana, what you are going to get, that is called sadhana. By the help of your sadhana, what you are going to get, that is called sadhana. Sadhya vastu usually is it prayojan. So, sambandha with your prayojan, that is the basic thing. Many times Mahaprabhu in Chaitanya Charitamrita has been speaking. You know, Shaddha Sadhana Tattva finally, what is, you know, Shaddha Sadhana Tattva in course of Shaddha Sadhana Tattva, Mahaprabhu wanted to speak Sambandha Abhidhya Prayojan, this Tattva. Everywhere, Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this Tattva. Without having the idea, clear idea about Sambandha Abhidhya Tattva, Sambandha bin, you are not going to discover your Sambandha with Krishna. There is no Adhikar. You know, even Kanishta Adhikar, even no Kanishta Adhikar. So you are not going to discover your relationship. So Sambandha, if Diksha means Sambandha. Diksha, this word means actually Sambandha Gyan. If there is no Sambandha Gyan, then your Diksha is not perfect Diksha. You are not going to realize that you have your eternal relationship with Krishna, Bhagavan. So accordingly you are not trying. So Sambandhagan, if Sambandhagan is not there, then your Diksha is not complete. So everywhere, anywhere and everywhere, first of all Mahaprabhu wanted to establish this Sambandha Vidya Prayojan, Gyan. Sambandha means you should discover your relationship with Supreme Lord, then you can discover your duty, what you should do by the help of Gurudev, and you can go on doing it, and what is the ultimate goal that you are going to get, you hope to get. That is Sambandha Vidya Prayojan. So, sadhana is Ovidya. Ovidya. Sadhana means Ovidya, the procedure. Bhakti is a natural function of your soul, and bhakti is action. Bhakti doesn't mean dry philosophy. Bhakti means you have to do something. You are doing Savan Kirtan, Smaran, Bandhan, Pada Sevan, ninefold of Bhakti and 64 different kind of Bhakti. Different, you know, 64 different types of Bhakti modes are there, written in Bhagavatam, Rasamrita, everywhere. So, 9 different kind of mode is there, basically. And with the help of sadhana, what you are going to get, that is called sadhya. That is called sadhya. Sadhya vastu ke prayojan bale. That is called prayojan. Prayojan means what you are going to get. When all human being, actually whole, when man going to do something, of course there is some target. What is that target? When man going to do anything, suppose service, business, study, you know, anything, whatever he is doing. When man going to do something, of course there is some target. Without target he is not going to do. What is the target? No, without target he is not doing anything. But What is the target of that target? Ultimately, what he want to get enjoyment. To get enjoyment, sukh, bliss. To get enjoyment, that is the final goal. Why doing service? Why doing study? Why playing? Why whatever they are doing, business, whatever they are doing. Ultimate goal is to get enjoyment. Because jivatma ananda amsa, so naturally they have natural instinct. This is a natural habit to get enjoyment. But they don't know the actual source of enjoyment. So they are blind, so they like to search enjoyment in this material world. In this material world. So whatever the human, whatever a man going to do, ultimate target is to get enjoyment. Whatever he is doing. Ananda. So, Ananda, now you can divide into two parts. One is material enjoyment. With the help of your sense organ, panchabhautik, material deva, material body, mind and buddhi, for the satisfaction of your, mental satisfaction you are doing. Another is, dharma jnana. For dharma. You have no clear conception about dharma, but you are thinking this is dharma. Okay. So, according to dharma, in this stage, according to your right, you are going to put some effort, energy, to get something benefit. So, it is called the second type is dharma jnana, for dharma. Dharma means parārthata. Actual dharma. Dharma means actual dharma. If you understand the meaning of actual meaning of dharma, if you understand, dhri plus man dhatu, by the help of which you can get stability. You can get stability. No frickle, restless condition. And also, Bhagavad Dharma means, I already discussed long ago, Hanumanji, in front of Hanumanji Maharaj, Dronachal Prabhupada wanted to put this question. Krite patikritam esha dharmo sanatanaha. What do you mean Bhagavad Dharma, Sanatana Dharma? Krite patikritam. Sanatana Dharma, Bhagavad Dharma mean always gratefulness. Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, krite pratikritam. Whatever you are getting benefit, you like to do something. Krite pratikritam. Krite pratikritam esha dharma sanatana. So, if you, with deep philosophy, you think, whenever you take breath, we have different kind of responsibility. Rishirin, Pitririn, Devarin, Bhuturin, all different kind of rin, we are indebted. Whenever we are going to take birth in this material world, it is written in Shastra, Rishirin, Pitririn, Devarin, Bhutarin, naturally. So, Varnasam Dharma, it is, you can go through Manu Sangita, you can find Manu Maharaji giving expression, those who are leading their Varnasam Dharma, they can take care of, and those jivas there, around them, those who are following Varnasam Dharma, they must be careful to help them. Even those who are leading Gyasala, they must help sannyasis, Brahmajde, Priyo. If they are going to help a kapat sannyasi, then the result getting negative result, like I am not responsible. So anyway, Manu Maharaj speaking, the Devri. So naturally, when you are going to take bath, you have Rishirin, Rishirin, Pitririn, Devarin, Bhutarin. Four different kind of rin. Mane, you are indebted to them. Rishirin means you have to pay the debt. You are indebted to those Rishi money. Because they are giving their so knowledge and everything, you will have to discuss and follow in your own life, you will have to apply. And this way you will have to discuss what all they wrote before, Rishi, their writings, everything, you will have to follow them. This way you can pay to Rishi Munis. Rishi Muni, they are writing so many things, instruction you have to follow, and you can apply in your own life. So this way you can discuss this point also to others. Rishirin. It's called Rishirin. Devarin mean those demigods, they are in the heaven. They are going to help us because they are getting responsibility from Supreme Lord to take charge of different cabinet. Indra Maharaj is going to get the charge of heaven. Varun Maharaj is going to take the charge of water. You know, this way Pavan Maharaj is going to take the charge of wind, how and when. This way actually, or Suryadev is going to take charge of light, you know, heat, everything. This way all demigods, they are getting response. This already in front of Devahuti Ma. Madbhayat Bhatubati. Surjastapati Madbhayat. Kapilji Maharaj speaking. Ma, mother, actually those wind blowing in my fear. The sun going to rise in my fear. Be careful. You know. This way we are getting rain, we are getting water, we are getting light, we are getting what, everything we are getting, all facility. Even the crops and, you know, flower, fruits, everything. You are not going to collect anything from outside this material world. You are all getting, all facilities are already there given by Supreme Lord. And you are getting the Brahma already giving instruction to those, Jivatma, those who are Jiva, you can help the Manava, those human beings, you can help those demigods, you can help them, they can also help you. This way, mutual cooperation, those demigods can help you. You can also do yajna and this, that, offer something to demigods. This way, you can get benefit. This way, you can, you know, go on leading your material life this way. So, Rishirin mean you will have to pay something, you will have to, you know, hear the instruction given by Rishi Muni, you will have to pay them back. How you can, you have to apply those principles in your life. Also, you will have to distribute this knowledge with somebody, you know. This way, actually, Rishirin. Suppose you are learning something, you are going to give this, you know, knowledge to somebody. This way, Rishirin, you can pay. And Devarin means this way you will have to worship demigods, everything. You will have to yajna, everything you will have to do. You have to offer Indraya Swaha, Varunaya Swaha, you know, Pavandevaya Swaha. You know, this way you have to offer. This way you can pay them. So, Rishirim, you know, Devrin and Pitririn, how you can finish, how you can pay Pitririn? Pitririn, according to Vedic culture, Vedic system, if you are going to follow this, you know, I am speaking about Vedic system. Outside world, there is no procedure. What I can see, they are fallen, totally fallen. So, Pitririn means if you can give birth to a son, if you marry, after that, if you can give birth to a son, then it is good because that son is going to do Shraddha. Shraddha, you know, when we are going to die, who can do Shraddha? Those who are leading family life, you know, for getting son. But otherwise, who can give pinda, funeral, cake and water yearly, or even fast, This way, actually, why man going to marry? Because ultimately, they are going to get the facility, they can get putra, son, and that son can offer water and everything, Shraddha, everything. In Gita also, in the beginning chapter, there is Arjuna speaking, if all people, they are going to die, then who can do this, you know, activities, Vedic activities, like Shraddha, everything, all, you know, big problem. Arjuna speaking to Krishna. This way actually, Pitru rin, you can pay. Your forefather, you can take bath and pay water and funeral care, everything to them. You have to do everything. This way, Pitru rin, you have to, and those who are, you know, understanding something deep, they can recite Gita, Bhagavad for the satisfaction of their, you know, father, forefather. Those who are foolish, they are not going to understand this point. So this way you can give Pitru-rin also, you can pay. And Bhuta-rin means you are taking birth here. All Jivatma, you can find some ants, birds, everything there around you. So it is your duty to arrange something for them also. If you are going to, because when you are going to cook, when you are going to do everything, the jiva, anywhere you are, when you are drinking water, when you are taking bath, anyway, some fine jivas are dying. You cannot understand. So Bhuta-rin anyway will have to be with, you know, with some positive mood to help all jiva around you somehow. You know, that with different moods, some, you know, people, they are having some fine idea, they can give prasadam, mahaprasadam, jagannath to jiva. In Puri you can go. They are offering to kukur, go, mane gomata, to dog, they can give this way there. And those who are having no, this kind of ideas, if not there, they can follow general procedure, they can make some chapati and everything, rice, or they can offer to some beggar, everything, they are coming outside. Grihastha man can give. And they are going to beg. This is the duty. Also, I have seen those Brajavasis sometimes, those who are staying in Vrindavan, here, there, in different place, in UP. Here I don't see. They are going to offer some powder sugar in front of ant. Those ant, in a hole they are staying, and they are going to put some heap, some, you know, sugar. They can take this way. To birds, they are giving some wheat and everything, you know, rice and paddy in front of them. They can take. This way, they have their positive mood to help all jivata around them. But ultimately, this is general rules. But when you are going to enter into the area of Bhagavad Dharma, when you are going to enter into the area of Bhagavad Dharma, in that case, this is not. In that case, you can ignore it. Because Naraji Maharaj already told that if you are going to serve Krishna, I mean Bhagavan, then you can do only Bhagavad Seva. You need not play your head over this thing. That is why I told, no, Dhavan Nimilitova Netre no Spalit na Katid Skalit na Patid Iho. That's why he told those who are going to follow Bhagavad Dharma, they need not play there. Their duty all can be done by this procedure. Jatha tarar mulnisi chanena tippanti tatskanda bhujo pasaka pranupaharas jathendriyanam tathiva sarva arharanam achyutejya. Through achyutejya, when you are going to serve achyuta, Bhagavan Vishnu, Bhagavan Krishna, in that case no duty can be. Devarsi bhutatmaninam pittinam nayam rinicha rajana. You know, this sloka also I discussed. So this way you are not going to, you need not serve anything. When you are doing Bhagavad Seva, automatically all of the Seva can be done. All automatically. If you are going to do, you know, Bhagavad Seva, then automatically all other seva, ancillary seva can be done. You need not play your head. So this way, you know, first of all, Raya Maharshi going to speak about this, the basic thing, that why people going to follow their, you know, regulated life, they should follow their regulated life. So Sadharma Acharan. Sadharma Acharan, suppose one Sudra is there, he is going to follow his own duty. He is scavenging everything he is doing. You know, there, Kshatriya, Vaishya, you know, Brahman, or yeah, Sadharma Acharan, they can do. Sadharma acharan Vishnu bhakti hoy. So somehow they are going to follow their sadharma, and according to their right, they can ultimately they can understand. If they can understand this detailed procedure, they can get bhakti. So this way there is a the procedure manav ganj, and so when you are doing some karma, have some target, so that target I already saw to get enjoyment. Ultimately the second type enjoyment mean material enjoyment related to your panchabhautik body, mind and brain, intellect. Another category I already told, dharmer jonno, and dharma mean paratparota. Whenever you are going to follow some dharma, I know they are not going to confess Isai dharma, Christian dharma, Bauddha dharma, any dharma they are going to follow has some indication to do something good for others, but they are just going to show opposite. Any dharma, dharma Isai dharma also, it is written in Quran, even if you have no right to catch one bird and keep inside your, you know, inside your, you know, in trap, you know, case, you have no right. In Isai dharma Quran it is written, even you have no right to catch a bird and put inside case, because it is all jiva, all maybe fish or bird or beast, all, you know, they are the son of that Allah, I mean Supreme Lord, but they don't like to follow this thing. So for dharma, if you are doing something, especially those who are going Vedic dharma, for them especially I am speaking, and I am giving example and general example for other also, but here actually second time they can search some benefit, they can do some dharma parartha paratha for God, tadiya vastu, sadhu, mahat, gomata, brahmanadi, for them they like to do something good. It is called actually dharma parartha paratha. Parartha paratha, sartha paratha, nishartha paratha and parartha paratha is so deep philosophy. Sartha paratha means selfishness. Sartha paratha, nishartha paratha, without any selfishness, without any selfishness, okay, you are not going to get any benefit. But still there is some fine benefit you like to get. That is one name, fame. That's why sartha paratha means selfishness. But when you are going to say that I am not selfish, I am going some doing some service without any interest, but I can prove that there is some secret interest. That is called sartha paratha, nishartha paratha, and parartha paratha is a soul benefit. It's not at all a smell of interest. That Guru Vaishnava, they are going to do something good for common people, bonded soul. That is called parartha paratha. What is the ultimate target of this parartha paratha? The ultimate target of parartha paratha is to increase the consciousness of jiva. If their consciousness is open fully, then this is called parartha paratha. That is the topmost benefit that I can do for others. What benefit? Because if I can help them, Prabhupada also told many times, to help men, to help people to increase their consciousness up to the extreme level is called paropokar, parartha paratha. It is called actually parartha paratha. If you are not interested about this, you know, that thing, only if you like to do some service for their body and mind, but X mission, Y mission, they are doing some service, giving clothes and food to food for life, everything is related with body. But parartha paratha is related with atma. They like to increase. The Sadhu Guru Vaishnav, they are always busy to help others to increase their consciousness up to the extreme level, so that they can realize their position, they can stop crying, repenting this way. So this way they are in Bhagavad Gita Mahapuran, you know, pratham, first of all, prakarne, the sadhana when you are doing, you are getting some enjoyment also. And the target you are going to get, the target you are going to get, it is nasar. Nasar means not going to stay, no stability. No stability. So, one kind of enjoyment there also. And sadhya vastu, what you are going to get, because dharma, artha, kama, moksha, that is the general target of general people. Dharma, artha, kama, moksha, na, this is the general target. You know, Rantideva was not targeting, Rantideva doing some service in such a way. Ultimately, he could make a direct link with Supreme Lord. You know, karma mistha bhakti. But here I am speaking, dharma, artha, kama, moksha. Moksha. General people, they are busy with dharma, artha, kama, moksha. That's why this dharma, artha, kama, moksha, that is their target. That's why they are giving donation. That's why doing their parikram, they are doing with some material end. They are giving some donation. They are doing something, doing archan. Everything they are doing, but ultimately they have some target. So dharma, artha, kama. Dharma means this dharma, general dharma, what I am speaking, those are varnasrama dharma, they are having some basic idea, they are doing. But out of that, they like to get some material benefit. Dharma, that is their conception of dharma. That is their conception of dharma at present. They don't understand Bhagavad Dharma. So dharma they are following, they are saying, we are following dharma. Okay, you are following dharma. So through dharma, they are following, they are getting dharma, artho, they are doing dharma, artho, kama, moksha. When they are following dharma, they like dharma, artho. They like to get artho. Artho means they get to get some benefit, artho. Suppose they are doing service, get money, dharma, artho. Kama, enjoying. They have to fulfill their, gratify their sense organ and mind, everything. So dharma, artho, kama. So I was bound to speak long ago, that even in Satya Yuga, Teta Yuga, Dapur Yuga, there was everybody busy, almost everybody busy with enjoying, enjoyment. The procedure of enjoyment was not so bad. The procedure of enjoyment, calm. This enjoying mood was so not, what was not so dirty as we are watching at present. It's far better. Hiranyakashipu want to enjoy this, that, they are enjoying. That procedure at present, you know, so dirty, they are not going to follow any rules and regulations, nothing. So, dharma, artha, kama, come in, they are going to gratify their sense organ, everything. They are going to fulfill. The procedure was more, far better on those days. At present, it is so dirty. So dharma artha kama and moksha mean they like to finish. They like to draw some conclusion of their life. What is that? Moksha. Moksha mean they never like to get any pain in future. After their, you know, dharma artha kama, moksha mean they like to finish this problem of getting pain. But it is not possible. They like to finish pain. Dharma artha kama moksha. Moksha means all finish. All problem over. They like to finish. So this meaning, what do you mean? Moksha means those Mayavadis, they moksha mean they like to submerge with Brahma. They like to submerge, this Jivatma can submerge with Brahma. Then there is, you know, no problem, no separate existence. If there is no separate existence of Jivatma, then who can suffer? All problem finish. This way, moksha, and those who are Buddhist, you know, they like to explain different way. They are also explaining different way. Those are impersonal Brahma effulgence, you know, those who are, you know, Mayavadis, this way. And Buddhist also like to finish Nirvana. This body finish, then no problem can come again. Prabhupada speaking, it is this kind of effort is totally wrong. You should not do it. You know, is one kind of suicide, is kind of one kind of suicidal squad. Dharma to kam moksha, but according to Guru Gauriya Darshan, according to Vaishnav Darshan, according to Vaishnav Darshan, it is written, dharma artho kam moksha mean, moksha mean mukti, they like to get mukti. Buddhist, that's why it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, those who are Mayavadi, Mahaprabhu speaking, Ved mukhe Mayavad Buddha ke odhik. This Mayavad, they are more than Buddhist. Why? Why? Well, a Buddhist, at least we can know they are Buddhist. They don't like to follow Veda. Bikarma nirato. Just opposite of written in Veda, they're doing. Bikarma. So, externally I can go and say, oh, he is Buddhist, Pasanda. We should not go there. No, see even their face. You have to take bath with all clothes. You know, sachel, Mahaprabhu speaking. And you have to take bath. I mean, manasnan, different kind of snan, mantra snan, manasnan, dibbo snan, different kind of snan, taking bath there. Mantra snan. You can take bath by mantra. You can look at sun. Dibbo snan there, mantra snan there. You know, different kind of snan. Taking bath is there. So you'll have to take bath. You know, whenever meet, you can meet with one pasanda, Vaishnava Aparad, everything, you will have to take, you have to look, you have to think the lotus feet of, you know, Jagannath, you will have to look the, see, internally, you have to look the lotus feet of Gurudev. Externally, you can see at Sangor also. This way, you have to purify yourself. You know, manasna, apavitra, apavitra, sarva, vasagato, viva, jasvarat, pundrika, akshams, sabajyavantaram, suchi, bayavantaram, suchi. If you can think about Patit Pavan Jagannath, from outside you can look. If you can think about Patit Pavan Jagannath, you can get fascinated. You can purify yourself. So constant remembrance of Bhagavan is the best procedure to keep yourself pure. Now, those who are Buddhist, Mahaprabhu speaking, Ved mukhe mayavad bodh ke odhik. Those who are mayavad, they are more dangerous than Buddhist. Because externally I can see they are Buddhist, so I cannot go there, I can avoid them. But mayavadi, they are going to keep Veda in front of them. So everybody goes, Maharaj, Veda is there. So Sanatana Dharma, they can confuse, they can go there. But ultimately, they can get big punishment. They cannot get bhakti. So Vedbukhya Mayavad Bodh ke Odhik is more dangerous. They like to submerge with impersonal Brahmo effulgence. You know. And Buddhists like to finish, you know, their or death and birth, this problem finish. Nirvana. This way actually, but our Gauriya philosophy, Gauriya Darshan, as per the vichar of Vaishnavas, Muktir hitva annatha rupam sarupena vyavasthiti tu mukti. Salvation, mukti. When you can get genuine mukti? Genuine mukti, genuine salvation, mukti, you can get when you can get bhakti. Then you can discover your eternal future. Then it is mukti, when you can get entry into eternal world. So, muktir hitva annatha rupam. Sarupana sarupena vyavasthiti iti mukti. Jive sarup hoy Krishna nitya das. When you can realize that you are the eternal servant of Krishna as a whole. Eternal servant of Krishna. You are the general. After that rasa tattva different, you know, that is different. But basically we have to feel that you are the eternal servant of Supreme Lord. Jive sarupha Krishna nitya das. If you can establish in this point continuously, if you can feel really so, then you are actually mukta. Then material in the bondage cannot stand in your life. But who can feel? Who can get this kind of mukti? First of all, you'll have to get this kind of mukti. Because otherwise, Hari Bhajan cannot start. মুক্তির হিতা অন্যথা রূপম স্বরূপেন ব্যবস্থিত ইদ মুক্তি। ফার্স্ট অফ অল ইউ উইল হ্যাভ টু রিয়ালাইজ দ্যাট ইউ আর দ্য ইটার্নাল সার্ভেন্ট অফ কৃষ্ণ ফ্রম হার্ট। মুক্তির হিতা অন্যথা রূপম জীবের স্বরূপ হয় কৃষ্ণ দিদ। দেন মায়া ক্যান নট মায়া ক্যান নট পুট ইম ইন ট্রাভেল এনি মোর ইস কল ইউ ক্যান রিয়ালাইজ ইউর স্বরূপ এন্ড আফটার দ্যাট ইউ ক্যান কাট মায়া দেন ইউ ক্যান গেট এস্টাবলিশড ইন হরি ভজন হরি সেবা আফটার দ্যাট ইউ নো ফার্স্ট অফ অল স্বরূপ সিদ্ধি স্বরূপ সিদ্ধি স্বরূপ সিদ্ধি ফাইনালি ইউ হ্যাভ টু রিয়ালাইজ ফ্রম হার্ট। And after that, that's why Rantidip got Sarup Siddhi. He could realize. So you are serving Supreme Lord in different form. Whenever he is going to serve a beggar, one rishi, one dog, he is always feeling inside them, my all-providing Supreme Lord is there. With this mood, you are serving. So, first of all, Sarup Siddhi. Parikshit Maharaj first got Sarup Siddhi. So after that Vastu Siddhi, when we are going to leave your body and going to enter into eternal seva, finally, Vastu Siddhi is called. So this way actually, first of all, you see, try to understand, those who are going to follow Vaidic rules and regulations, they are speaking, and Vaidic, you know, they are going to Varnasam Dharma first. Varnasam Dharma, in Vishnu Dharma it is written, if they are going to follow Varnasam Dharma properly, then they can satisfy Vishnu. If you can satisfy hundreds of birds, it is written in Shastra, hundreds of birds consecutively, you are going to satisfy Supreme Lord by following the exact procedure of Varnasam Dharma, then you can get the post of Brahma. Brahma. They follow what I say. So, surely you can satisfy, but it's not pure devotion, pure bhakti. So, Prabhu wanted to hear more details. Then after that, Raya Mahasaya was bound to speak about Karmarpan from Gita. Yad karosi, yad asnasi, yad yuhosi, dadasi yad. Yat tapasasi kantiyo tat kurusha madarpanam is the procedure. Then, why Mahaprabhu again speaking? It is also external thing. You will have to speak. First point. Those who are Varnasam Dharma following, they have their link with, you know, surrounding world, bondage. They are trying to follow. Somehow they can satisfy. But when you are going to Karmarpan, you are going to give everything unto lotus feet of Vishnu, then why this question coming? Why Mahaprabhu speaking, it is external? They are offering everything. But Maharaj, they are going to offer. I know they are going to offer. But still inside their heart, they are going to feel some doership. They are going, this is contamination. Krishna Karmarpan's Sarva Sadhan Sadhusa. Raya Mahasaya is saying, well, you want to hear about, you know, Sadhu Sadhan Tattva. In course of, you know, this, you know, explanation, I like to speak this one. Mahaprabhu says, it's okay. Krishna Karmarpan Sarva Sadhusa. Raya Mahasaya is speaking. Mahaprabhu is speaking, okay. But it is not final. It is external thing. Because when somebody is going to show Karmarpan, but still, there is some, you know, false ego. Has some false ego there. Sartha bhojana juna dade uddishto na. You know, it is written that when they are following this Karmarpan, but as Gita it is written, they should follow this procedure in such a way that there is no contamination at all. No contamination. No self-interest, no contamination, but who can follow this procedure? So, Karmarpan also one can, you know, say it's not pure, there are two. So, from Bhagavatam, Sant Bhagavad Ji Mahapuran, Raya Mahasaya speaking, नेहो यत कर्मो धर्मायो न विरायो विरागायो कल्पते न तीर्थ पदो सेवायोई जीवन ओपी मृतो ही स। व्हाट इज द टारगेट ऑफ कर्म? उत्तर आंसर धर्म। धर्म शब्देर परार्थता आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन एंड सार्थो मीन्स सेल्फिशनेस। सो व्हेन एट ऑल यू आर गोइंग टू डू सम धर्म इट शुड बी विदाउट एनी सेल्फिश एंड। कर्म सकलेर व्हाट इज द लक्ष्य देव कर व्हाट इज द टारगेट ऑफ कर्म that you have to satisfy dev dijo brahman guru and brahman guru dev devota you have to satisfy dev pavitri guru or hari seva ultimately hari if you are not going to satisfy then it is akarma bikarma akukarma it is not actual karma if you are not going to follow exact procedure then it is not karma then big so neho yat karma it is not at all karma because externally you falling but your target is not pure neho no iho yat karma dharmayo no viragayo kalpate you are doing karma that not going to do any service of dharma according to your own standard unright and also that karma not going to create detachment, not going to develop detachment inside you. And Bhagavatam it is written, neho no iho yat karmo dharmayo no viragayo kalpati. Karmo, why people doing? Because ultimately karmo can give you full detachment. This is the status of karma. This is the condition of karma. So what I can do? If you are not going to grow detachment, like Shobari Muni, Shobari Muni did opera, after that opening his family life, 50 different wives, after that finally going to feel that is useless. Viragaya kalpate. Na tirtha pada sevayai, tirtha pada mean guru, guru, Vaishnav, guru, dijo, guru, hari, gomata, vipro, you are not going to serve anything, in that case, that is not at all, proper procedure. Neho yat karma dharmayo na viragayo kalpa, which not going to develop your detachment. You are going to go to karma. And you are not going to get any inspiration to serve Brahman, Dijo Guru, Hari, then it is useless. What you can do? Neho yat karmo dharmayo na viragayo kalpate na tirtha padah sevayai jivan mito hi sa. Jivan opi mito hi sa. You should understand. Neho yat karmo dharmayo na viragayo kalpate na tirtha padah sevayai jivan opi mito hi sa. You can remember that Kardam Rishi, when leading family life, Kardam Rishi, and also, Kardam Rishi, he was also speaking this way. And after that, Kashyap, they also, Aditi, Diti, they are also speaking in third canto. That with wife, we are going to lead this life, so that ultimately we can get detachment and finally get bhakti. If bhakti is not ultimate target, then what use? Useless. So this way, this dharma is not at all dharma. You are following dharma, but the target is not good, so the result is also not good. That's why Mahaprabhu is speaking that pure dharma, I like to hear more about it. Then ultimately you hear, then when you are going to offer everything, and when you are yoga, dan, tapo, everything you are going to offer, that is also not pure. You are going to offer. There is smell of attraction, affinity, self-interest. If you are not growing attachment for Hari, then what use? No use. So, Jivan Mito Isa means Jivan Opi. Though he is living, you can see he is a, you know, living, you know, he, running here and there, living, living body. But, Shastra speaking, it is also dead body. But the target is wrong. They are not going to develop, they are less interested to get attachment for Vishnu Charan. So, Jivan Mito Isa. They are following Dharma, general Dharma. But still, they are not successful this way. This way, actually, Raya Mahasaya is going to give answer. Mahaprabhu is not satisfied. Mahaprabhu wanted to hear more about, you know, deep philosophy. And this way, actually, today, we like to stop here. And tomorrow, from here, I can go on discussing more. So, though from Brahma Sangita, you can remember I started with a sloka, that is our target. Preman jana charita bhakti vilo chanena santaho sadaiva hidaye shubilo kayanti yam sam sundaram achinta guna sarupam govindavadi purusham tamaham bhajami vancha kalpadurvasi ke basindu bevacha patitanam pavane bhavishna vyo namo namah.